Almighty God, before whose presence the angels veil their faces with reverence and love, we acknowledge your glory and worship you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, eternal Trinity.
Blessing, honor, glory, and power be to our God forever and ever. Amen.
As we gather tonight to celebrate the birth of Jesus, we enter into the presence of holiness. Gathered around his manger, we are unworthy guests. Yet his very presence in our world testifies to God's love for us. He earnestly desires to bring an end to our guilt of sin. By his grace, he grants forgiveness. Confident then in this love, we confess our sins before God. Father, we humbly bow before you this night, filled with awe at your great love for us. We know we are unworthy of such love because of our sins of thought, word, and deed. Yet in the midst of our failings and desperate need, you have given us the gift of your only Son as our Savior. We give you thanks for sending the Christ child into our world. Forgive our sin and fill us with everlasting peace for the sake of Jesus, who was laid in the manger, who shed his blood on the cross, and who now lives and reigns for us. Amen. Standing in the presence of our holy God, I announce his peace to you. The separation between God and man, woman, and child has been healed by Jesus Christ. He was born, died, and rose again to reconcile us to God. Bearing this good news, I therefore, as a called and ordained servant of Christ, announce God's grace to you in his stead and by his command. I therefore forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Amen. Amen. Ascribe to the Lord, O families of nations.
Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength.
Ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name.
Bring an offering and come into his courts.
Worship the Lord in the splendor of his holiness.
Tremble before him all the earth.
Come, let us sing for joy to the Lord.
Let us shout aloud to the rock of our salvation.
Let us come before him with thanksgiving.
Oh,
you may be seated. The Old Testament reading from Isaiah chapter 9. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of the shadow of death, a light has dawned. You have enlarged the nation and increased their joy. They rejoice before you as people rejoice at the harvest, as men rejoice when dividing the plunder. For as in the days of Midian's defeat, you shattered the yoke that burdens them, the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor. Every warrior's boot used in battle and every garment rolled in blood will be destined for burning, will be fuel for the fire. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, and establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this. This is the word of our Lord.
Yeah.
The epistle reading is from Titus chapter 3. But when the kindness and love of God our Savior appeared, he saved us, not because of righteous things we had done, but because of his mercy. He saved us through the washing of rebirth and renewal by the Holy Spirit, whom he poured out on us generously through Jesus Christ our Savior, so that having been justified by his grace, we might become heirs, having the hope of eternal life. This is a trustworthy saying, and this is the word of our Lord. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria, and all went to be taxed. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds, abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And suddenly, the angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone all about them, and they were sore afraid. But the angel said unto them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign unto you. You shall find that babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has happened, which the Lord has made known unto us. And they came with haste, and they found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying that was told them concerning this child. And all who heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary, she kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all that they had heard and seen, as it had been told unto them.
Oh, Welcome. I thank you. I thank you for taking the time to listen to me this night. I thank you for hearing me out. I know you don't like me. I know you look down upon me because I'm not clean. I'm not well kept. I know even the thought of being around me tonight probably has you feeling very uncomfortable. You don't like shepherds. I get it. I really do. But something happened last night that you simply must know. So I thank you. I thank you for giving me this chance. Last night, it started out just like any other night. Samuel and Marcus and I, we were just doing what we do. We were keeping the flock, taking turns, resting, waking, guarding the sheep, guiding the sheep, leading the sheep to the water. We were making sure the flock was well cared for. And it was a peaceful night, as I'm sure you all remember. It was a very peaceful night. Maybe here in town, maybe it was a little restless and crowded because of all the extra guests that are here for that census. But out in the field, it was as calm as ever. Not even a cloud in the sky, not a storm in sight. We had a perfect view of the stars as they dazzled in the night sky. And one of those stars was more bright, was more magnificent than any star I've ever seen. But as I lay there on the hillside with one of the injured lambs from the flock in my arms trying to sing the babe to sleep, the night sky just, it lit up. It was so bright, so alarming, so sudden. It happened out of nowhere. It was almost like the night passed away and became day. But I don't know how to tell you what the three of us saw next. You already think me to be a fool. But I must. I must try. It was the most terrifying thing that any of us have ever seen. It had the appearance like a man. I mean, in most ways, he looked like you or like me, but he wasn't. He had wings. Large wings, six of them. And with two of them, he was keeping himself hovering in the heavens just above us. And with the other four, he was covering himself. It was almost like he was shielding us from himself. Almost like he knew we were afraid of him. And for good reason. The very sight of him made the bones inside of me tremble. Just as quickly as the sky had lit up, this angel had descended down upon us from heaven. Not one of the three of us could even mutter a sound, let alone put a word together. We were terrified. But this angel, he had a message to give to us. And he did it. And I'll never forget those words. They're seared into my mind. Fear not. For behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling cloths and lying in a manger. These words, they melted my heart. Just as quickly as I'd been seized with fear when the angel arrived, when he began to speak, the fear, it melted away. We were overwhelmed with calm. We were at peace again. And oh, those words. Why would the good Lord of heaven and earth speak such words to us? I mean, just look at me. I'm worthless. I'm an outcast, and not even the least among you in this place, not even the least of you would consider for a single second to hire me as a servant in your home. And it's not just that. I don't deserve any of this. I'm wicked. I haven't kept the commands of God. I haven't even been to worship in his temple any time in recent memory. I certainly don't give any sacrifices or the offerings that the Pharisees are always saying I should be giving. I've hated my brother. And I've held grudges against all of you for the way that you've treated me. I'm a sinner. I'm a poor, miserable sinner. And yet this angel came to us. And he gave us the greatest news that we've ever heard. It's been so long. Not one of us here has even seen a prophet. But our scribes, our priests, they tell us about them. They tell us about how God has made us all of these great promises, how we have a God who loves his people, how God has made plans to send a Savior, a Messiah to us. And he did. We've heard nothing for generations, nothing until last night. The Savior of the world. Our Messiah, he's here. Just like Samuel said long ago that the Christ would come from the house of David, just like Micah said long ago that the Lord of Lords would come from Bethlehem, the Christ, the one who is going to save us from our sins and from death and from this wretched world that we live in, he's here. I couldn't believe the news. This angel. I couldn't believe the news that this angel was bringing to me. Could it be? Could it really be? But before we could even get to our feet, There was another brilliant flash of light in the sky, and when we finally were able to look up again, we were no longer looking at just one angel. The heavens were filled with them. And even if we'd had all night, we couldn't have counted them. It was like an army. But instead of coming at us with instruments of war, instead of coming to us to kill us, like I thought they might be, they began to sing. And it was the most melodious sound. It was the most beautiful song I've ever heard. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased. Peace. We definitely had peace last night. It was almost as though there were no troubles in the world anymore. It almost as though we needn't worry about anything anymore. And maybe it's true. If this baby is the Christ, maybe all is well with my soul. Before we even had the chance to ponder the things that we'd just seen and just heard, just as quickly as they'd arrived, they disappeared. And it was night again. It was still the same night, right? Still the same beautiful sky. That one bright star was still in the heavens, almost as though it was pointing us to go to Bethlehem. Almost as though it was inviting us, inviting the world to come and see. And so I turned. I turned to look at Samuel and Marcus, and I didn't have to say anything. You could see it on their faces. This was no dream. I hadn't just had some crazy dream. I hadn't fallen asleep on the job, I promise you that. This had been real. An angel had come to us and had given us great news, great peace, great joy. And we were so excited. It was Marcus who broke the silence. One of us would have eventually, but it was Marcus who suggested it. He said, let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing which has happened, which the Lord has made known to us. It was one of those moments. One of those moments where you just know everything is right. He didn't have to ask. We didn't have to answer. We were going. So I took that sheep that was in my arms, that little lamb, and I laid it down by its mother, and we ran. It's not far. It's not a far run from the hillside where we watch our flock to come here to Bethlehem, but we were just so excited. We were so filled with awe, so filled with amazement, so filled with wonder that we just couldn't wait. It still felt like an eternity. I know it wasn't that far, but this great gift was here. We've been waiting for it for so long, and it's finally here. The trip felt like it took forever. But we arrived. We arrived in your crowded city late last night. We arrived in the quiet, in the peacefulness, in the still of night. We arrived. What to say next? It was almost like that star was beckoning us. It was almost like we had been beckoned. We didn't need to ask for directions. We simply knew. I don't know how to explain it to you. We knew where to go. And so when we got to town, with haste, we went to the family of Joseph. We went to his relatives. We went to their home. And we found him. We found a baby boy, and we found his parents just inside. And that house was extra crowded, like I'm sure all of your homes are right now. It was extra crowded, and they had brought the animals inside to keep them safe, to keep them warm during the night. They brought them into the lower level, and it was right there. It was right there in the feeding trough in the floor. It was right there in that manger where they had just laid a fresh bed of hay. It was right there where the cows are supposed to eat. It was him. It is him. There's no doubt about it. This little boy is our Savior. He's here. The one we've been waiting for all these years, he's here. And so all that craziness, all that madness of our sprinting was over. And we made our way into the house. We greeted his parents. Joseph, let me tell you, Joseph's love for his young bride is unquestionable. He had that difficult task given to him that in the middle of her pregnancy, he had to move her here to Bethlehem. And he took care of her every step of the way. And then in the few weeks that it's been since they've arrived, as they continued to wait for the baby to be born, whatever she needed, whatever the baby needed, he did it. No questions asked, he was there. and Mary. Oh, Mary, I mean, she just gave birth last night. She had that mother's glow about her. You know that look. You know what I'm talking about. You've seen it before. But there was something different this time. This joy that she had on her face, it was like nothing I'd ever seen. It's so obvious. It's so obvious that she and her husband know who this boy is. But that didn't stop us from asking. And so we stood there and we listened as they told us their story. We listened as they told us about how both of them had been visited by an angel. And how this angel, he told them that the baby that would be born to Mary would be the very Son of God. And he even told them what to name the boy. He said that he would be the Christ, and that they should name him Jesus because he would save his people from their sins. I'm just so excited. Even here, even now, I didn't sleep at all last night. I can't. Jesus, he's born. Our Savior, the Messiah, has come for us. Our King is here. Even for me, the least of all people, Jesus has even come to save me. Jesus has even come to save me. Thank you, God. Thank you. Thank you for coming. Thank you for taking the time to hear my story, for coming to hear what I had seen last night, but there's nothing left for me to say. Just go and see for yourself. The Christ, he's come for you too.
Thank you.
At this point of the service, we will collect the offering. The offering is, just as a reminder to you, it's a family thing that we do as God's people in this place. So if you are a guest among us tonight, you don't have to make an offering. That's not been given to you to do, and that's fine. We welcome you. We're glad to have you among us, and we wish God's blessings to each of you. If you would, please do fill out the friendship registers, those blue books that you find at the center of the aisle. Three updates that I have for you on our prayer list this evening. The first is that mixture of Christian sadness and yet Christian joy. As I inform you that on Thursday of this week, Irma Sanderson of our congregation passed away. Irma was 102. She had lived an exceedingly long life, a wonderful gift from the Lord indeed. She had been a member of this congregation for years. In the recent years, though, she was living in Dodge Center in the care center over there. Her daughters, Betty and Ethel, specifically, will be keeping in our prayers tonight, and the funeral for Irma will be here on Wednesday morning at 11 o'clock this week, so you're welcome to join us for that. We also want to pray for Dorothy Sloniker. Dorothy is currently hospitalized up at St. Mary's. She fell earlier this week, did some damage to her vertebrae, but they've got a neck straightener kind of device on her at the moment, and they're just going to let that take time to help heal her vertebrae at this point. So she's up there, and she was up and eating breakfast this morning when I was able to visit. So she's in good spirits and celebrating Christmas with her family. So we rejoice in that too. We pray for Arnold Higgins. Arnold is the father of Sam Higgins. Sam was just married last week to Tracy, and the dad, Arnold, had just some severe health issues and was at home, and so the wedding was actually at the home so that he could see his son get married, and that was a tremendous blessing for him. He is on hospice care now. He fell and injured himself in ways that they don't anticipate recovery, so they have placed him into hospice care, but he was, again, excited to have seen his son get married, so we can rejoice at that as well. Please rise as we join together in prayer. Yahweh, Lord God of heaven and earth, we come before you this evening as your children, delighting, rejoicing in the gift of your Son, Jesus, born on Christmas morning to be our Savior, that he took on flesh, that God himself took on flesh to save us from sin, from death, and from the devil. We give you thanks, dear Lord. We also wish to pray today for all who are sick, for all who are hurting. We want to lift up to you Dorothy Sloniker, Arnold Higgins, Otto Kitzman, Florence Reinhardt, Dana Heimsness, Michael Elke, Larry Gilbert, and Lyndon Luke. And we want to pray for the family of Irma Sanderson, Lord. We are grateful that Irma was your daughter, and so we can rejoice, we can hope in the promise of the resurrection, and we pray that that same hope would be with her loved ones these days as they mourn her passing, as they miss their mother, as they miss their friend. We also want to pray for all of those around the world who are indeed sharing this good news tonight, the good news of a Savior born in Bethlehem. We pray, Lord, that you would bless your good news, that it would travel far and wide, that it would be heard by everyone. We pray these things, dear Lord, in the name of our Savior, Jesus Christ, and we join in praying the prayer that he has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. And the Lord look upon you with his favor and give to you his peace.
We thank you again for joining us. Thank you very much to the choir. Let's give them a hand for a very, very nice job. We appreciate that a lot. Good job. And a blessed Christmas to all of you.